full volume tagisthe.
Only here one dot, here one small are there. You see, this is there. You see, this is the one. This is going to be the bacterial culture. So you can see here one more. So you can see some of the colony, small colonies are there. You see, they all are the bacterial colonies. So this is by the plating method, what we have done earlier. So from this, what we have got it, we are going to consider this as to be a fungal source and we will do the staining. So it is a fungal culture. So what is the stain we are going to use here is lactophenum cotton blue stain. So we have to take a clean glass slide. So to this clean glass slide, we are going to add a drop of the lactophenol. This is the stain, what is we have got it, lactophenol stain. We are going to add a drop to the center of the slide. Then we have to sterilize the inoculation loop and take few cultures from the fungal culture plate and put or drop it on top of the slide where we have already placed the lactophenol. Then using a cover slip, we are going to place a cover slip on top of the sample in such a way that there is no any air bubbles which are going to be there on it. Okay. So let us first do this one. Then I will show you the preparation of other samples, how to do that. So first we will take the glass slide. So it must be clean. There must be no any dust or any unwanted contaminants on the slide. So they may disrupt the observation. So let us clean the slide thoroughly and then we will place it here. So this is lactophenol. The first step is to the slide, we will drop first the lactophenol to the center. So just take one small drop and then you can put it to the center. That is more than enough for us. So I've taken the lactophenol. Then now this is the culture. Okay. So now first thing is before taking it, just take the loop and we will sterilize it. So when we are taking the fungal cultures, let us be very careful in handling it. Otherwise, all the hyphae will be broken and the conidia pores also will get broken off and we will be able to take the proper treatment. Let us just wait for a few seconds. So what we will do is that very carefully, from the plate, we will take few of the cultures and then drop it on top of the So just with the needle, you can see that I am just very carefully, I'm just spreading it, not disturbing it much. Now we have to place the cup. So then I'm just taking one small glass cover slip. As we have said, we have to just place it at one end and release it slowly onto the slip. So you can see we have prepared the slide. So this is the first slide what we have prepared. So we will keep it aside for the observation later. By the time we prepare the other two samples also. So
Today we will see other two organisms. This is yeast sample. So what we have done is we have taken the baker's yeast and we have inoculated it in the distilled water. So you can see how turbid it is. So we will just take few drops from this one and place it on center of the slide. We are not adding any mounting agent, just in the water the sample is dropped and we will put the cover slip and focus it under the microscope. Okay, just small drop is needed. So just you mix the cultures one and just take a small drop and place it in the center. So we have taken baker's yeast only, which is commercially available. So both we have taken that one only. So we will take one more cover slip and just place it. So this is for the second plate. That is the yeast. Now we go to the sample fixation. In the glass slide. Then this is spirulina. So you must have seen the spirulina tablet. So from that spirulina tablet, they are all the spirulina you can see here. The sample. So we have inoculated that from some residue of that spirulina we have taken in the distilled water. Okay, so this we will take the sample because already it is green in color. Okay, so under the microscope also you'll be able to see it. So we are not putting any staining agent, just in water we are taking it. Just I'm taking a small sample now. Just placing it in the center. So here also I'm just putting it cover. So this is another plate what we have prepared now. So three samples we have done. So we will focus it under 10x and then at 40x and we will show you the results now. So let us take the first one and we will check it out. Let me put the 10x. Then we will immediately see it. I will show you now. You're able to see? You see the septum. You see the hyphae, how serrations are there?
Yes.
Yes. You can see the gonadophore. You can see this is only at 10x. It is very clear now. The zenda, see some spores are also there. Okay. You can see the spores also. Can see? Students are able to see it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. You can see the spores also, no? You can see the hyphae, single it is. Yes. There are no any branches also. Very clearly it is seen. Okay? So you can, for the exams, this is spot test we will give you. So you should be able to identify them. Okay? Shall I go to the next slide?
Yes,
is this clear
yes,
all
ma'am.
Of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. take a good sample for you so that you can see the spirals. They are actually dehydrated, they are dried, they are not live. So you cannot see them moving, but still you can see the spirals and the serrations in their body. So they are fragmented actually, but still there are some good spirals here. This is again at 40x. Yes, there is one spiral.
You're able to identify it?
Yes, ma'am.
Students?
Yes,
able
ma'am.
To see in the center spiral?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, the spirulina.
The yes, other ma'am.
Because what you're finding are its fragments, broken ones. But in the center, you're able to see it. Okay. So I'll try to focus it one more time. You're able to locate it, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So in the center, the spiral. Okay, so that is spirulina. In 40x only, I'm focusing it for you. 100x is not needed. Here.
So this is yeast. Many of them have started to do budding also. You can observe this is a 10x. I will show you later at 40x.
Magnify it at 40x and show you.
See some of them are budding, dividing. There are many numbers. You can keenly observe, means you can see even the nucleus also in the middle. You can see very clearly that they are oval in shape, they are not exactly spherical. In the center, you can see them bulged also. Okay, this is where it is budding also. You can see
some cells are budding, you see.
Yes,
are you able to see, students? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
40x. This is in 40x. You can see now. Are you able to see it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So you can see some here and there, some budding are also there. You're able to 100x see?
100x, I can adjust.
100x, ma'am, I'll see. Yeah, I'll try in 100x also.
Okay.
Put little more oil. Oil is enough.
Yes, students. Are you able to
yes,
see them?
Yes, ma'am.
You have to concentrate as individual cells. Then you can see and get the difference. Okay, since it is in water, you are seeing that they are moving. Nucleus also, you see, if you see properly in the center, you can see the nucleus also. Yes?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, you can see one which is moving. Okay. Budding is there, you see. You have to check out, you see cells as they are moving, they are budding, you see. You're able to see? So that is about this yeast. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll capture some good pictures and I will post it to you for your record and purposes. Okay? Okay,
okay,
so these are three microscopic observations of the samples.